Alright everyone, in today's video I'd like to talk about joint mobility. So what's joint mobility? My definition for that is an active range of motion of a particular joint, because there's a difference between active and passive. Let's say with passive I can push that joint in a further range of motion, but you won't necessarily have any control or strength in that range. Okay, so why that's important? So Gray Cook and Maibo, they have introduced one model which states that the joints are just like a stack of joints. So every joint has a distinct function. So they have a joint which is have a function of mobility, the other one has of stability, and so on and so on. They keep on changing like that. So our body is a stack of joints, and if one joint has a dysfunction, let's say it doesn't do the job that it's supposed to do, it's gonna affect the other joints up, I mean above or below. So why that is important? So when there is a dysfunction in the body, the different joints and muscles are trying to compensate. When compensations occur, they're normally doing things that they're not supposed to be doing, and under certain conditions, when that's so exaggerated, I would say, that can result in an injury and so on and so on. That can also limit your performance in training, you won't be able to move as well. So for instance, somebody's doing an overhead squat or just a squat overall, let's say keeping just a bar squat. Don't make it complicated. So somebody has a tight ankle joint, so doesn't have enough dorsiflexion in the ankle. That's gonna affect the joints above. So you see there's gonna be this torsal lean. Now typically when you do the squat, the person more upright, chest is out looking up, then the shin angle and torso angle, they're like they're parallel more or less, right? But when you don't have that ankle mobility, you compensate more with the hips. So we have this, this is the shin angle, and this is the torso angle, start to lean a bit more forward. See how people just leaning more forward, they kind of maintain that upright position. So a lot of people, they think, oh, that's the hips or that's the back or something like that. But just because the problem occurs there, that's where is the actual, I mean, the visible thing. You can see a problem, let's say in the back or in the torso, doesn't mean the problem is there. So the cause is somewhere else. That's why mobility is really important, as it can really affect you guys quite a lot. Another key thing for mobility, I mean common restriction, is upper body restriction, definitely more with the shoulder joint and scapula. So basically a lot of people, they have tight lats, so then overhead mobility pretty much is really difficult for them. I experienced this as well. That's mainly due to practicing BJJ, because you're always in this rounded back flexion position, so your muscles are quite tight. You don't get much tension as part of BJJ, as if you get, always you get submitted and so on, because you get too much exposure. So I'm trying to work on this one now as well currently, but there's always something to be working on. Even if you think that you have enough mobility and so on, there's always something that you need to address, simply because our lifestyle is so different nowadays than what it has been before, that we really do a lot of things that we shouldn't be doing. For example, like let's say sitting in a desk or chair or driving for a few hours, you have all these tight hips, so your hip flexors are getting so tight, affects your posture, so you must start getting anterior pivot and so on and so on, which again, if that affects your hips and your lumbar spine, that's also going to affect your T-spine, your thoracic spine and shoulders. So again, that is kind of really affecting the whole body overall. So it's really important to everybody to be working on their mobility, so they can be injury free, they can train well, they can move well, and don't do any compensations.